Greetings everyone, how's it going? Tim here, and today I want to play a bit of The Exiled, a new, as it calls itself, social MMORPG with open PvP crafting and settlement building, which is kind of interesting. So I got the key for free from the developers, but I think it's going to be free to play at some point. So, you know, I think you can try it right now for free for 7 days. It's still early access, as you can see over here. So there's a lot of things missing and expect some bugs and things like this. But, you know, I haven't launched it yet, haven't tried it yet. So let's go ahead and create our character and see what exactly the game looks like and, you know, what can you actually do there. Okay, so it seems like it's run on Unity Engine, which is, you know, kind of common for most of the indie games these days around, but it's anyway interesting to see an indie MMORPG. All right, that camera bound to mouse is, I am not sure if that's a good decision, but anyway, let's go ahead and try. So WASD to move. Okay, yeah, that is definitely not very nice. I am getting a bit of nausea. Okay, mouse to look around, left mouse button to attack. There we go. Okay. Sympathetic jailer. Okay. Space to loot. Knock him out. There we go. Space to loot. Okay, at least now the camera doesn't move. Loot everything. Cool. Yeah. Oh god, that is very nauseating, but okay, let's bear with it. Right, so we got a bunch of weapons. Try out different weapon classes. Okay, staff. What is that? Space train. So we can shoot bolts. Q. My brain. I don't know who thought that was a good idea, but I can tell you for a fact that it is actually not. Why the hell is my chat no longer above everything? Reset Windows position. Just give me a second to... always on top, yes, please. Can I be always on top now? No, okay. Can I switch to window mode maybe? There we go. Okay, I guess I have to play in a window mode because my chat overlay doesn't want to be in on top of the maximized window. I'm not sure why. I can't actually see the Twitch chat then. Okay, but whatever. Let's try. So, what is this? Health search. Heals one target close to your cursor. So like this. Okay. Yeah, that's a heal. Firebolt. Okay, so it's targeted thing. All right, I got that. Okay, what is this? War scythe. That looks kind of cool. So basic attack. Handle bash. Okay, so it's a cone attack. Got it. 60 damage, and then that is not a big difference in damage. Hemorrhaging chains pulls the target towards you, healing you if a projectile hits. Okay, so this actually heals you. That's kind of interesting. Totem, what is that? Okay, so you shoot. That looks like a witch doctor thing. Q is poison. Okay, so that poisons and I guess adds a debuff. Camera is absolutely nauseating. Revitalize slowly heals one target, increases resistance. Okay, so I can do that on myself, and this is basically damage over time, healing over time class. Bow. Okay, this is, I assume, just a hunter thing. Ensnaring shot, so this is probably pins the target in place. And then we can have a bow swing, which, okay, this is kind of close ranged. Okay, that looks kind of boring. Shield and spear. Okay, so we can poke him. We can pin down, and we can shield bash. I think I'm gonna go totem purely because damage over time sounds like fun. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay, let's see what we have here. There's a different armors. Okay, and it's so hard to read the text when the camera just jumps around constantly. Cut it. Who thought that this is a good idea for, like, seriously? Right, try out different armor classes, test abilities. Okay, so armor actually grants you ability. Okay, let's try rope. That looks kind of cool. I like it. I also seem to be some sort of a vision cone that is, if I turn around, I cannot actually see anything behind me. So it still shows the dummy for some reason, but I think it's supposed to be vision cone. Maybe it works only for humans. Right, so what does it give us? Blink. So I can now blink. Okay, nice. And F is aura of healing. Current rank 0, heal over time 40 per second. So if I enable it, I will basically heal anything around me. Makes sense, okay. Splint mail. That looks... wait, did I... No, that was a wrong... Yeah, okay, I changed it. Okay, that looks kind of not exactly the way it looks on a dummy, but okay. Ignore pain. All right, invulnerable to damage, but lose health over time. Ah, so it's kind of a debuff, I guess. Pushes multiple targets away from you and speeds you up to push some... if you push someone away. All right. Uh-huh. Leather armor. Yeah, that kind of is that some pattern that is tied to my account account or something among those lines? Because I thought there was like the basically if you buy into the game now, you get some cosmetic stuff for it. Okay, captivating sprint greatly increases your run speed. Drain life heals you for duration for the damage you deal. Okay, I don't think I need that, so I guess I will go with more protection. Or maybe I just go more heals. I mean, healing is always good, right? So we can have a blink and then we can have heals. I think that works good. So let's try that. Okay. Okay, we gotta kill that guy, I guess. Shoot him. That's... Oh, what? Okay, you can actually heal your enemies. Yeah, that's not very good. That's... what? The combat is a bit clunky. Okay, I can loot him, but he doesn't really have anything. Escape. Defeat. There we go. Loot materials from carcasses and meteorites, then craft better gear at workshop. Okay, so activate to claim. Will attack mo- So I cannot just loot, I need to activate. And then what the hell happens? What is this? Hungry snapper. What are you doing here? Okay, so they will just attack me. Can I loot him? But he doesn't have anything. Okay, we got, there's already three of them. I guess they are not, you know, a big pain in the ass to deal with because they are low level, but that seems like a horde mode defense just to get some resources. I'm not sure I'm a fan of that. And I'm seriously lacking any area of effect damage to actually kill those frogs somehow. Come on. Yeah, that didn't hit him. What? Or, oh, it's my pet. Is it? The blue one? I think it's my pet. There you go. Okay, now I can loot it and I get some... What the hell is that? Flux exp... No, wait. How do I... What is that? That is... Come on. No. There you go. Flux. Item XP. And it won't tell me what is that. Okay, whatever. Let's activate that. We got a pulsating egg spawning on us. I guess. And it has a timer. I guess we don't want that timer to go to zero. Okay, let's try. Oh, okay, that is a lot of eggs. Right, so far I wouldn't say the combat is very exciting. I mean, it's your typical like MMORPG point and click combat, I guess. It's very, very old school. On the other hand, I mean, it's supposed to be skill based, at least according to the description, but I am not convinced. Oh god, something spawned and it what? Explode? Whoa! Okay, it just exploded. Oh, it damages the resource thing, so I guess you don't want it to do that. Okay, loot everything. So it takes a bit of a time to pick up loot. I guess this is for the PvP aspect, since the game has like full PvP thing. Okay, let's see. Workshop. What can we craft? I guess we can craft a totem, right? Oh, that's interesting. What is that? So I say I wanna energy. Total balance. Okay, so I can put less of something, like less run speed. Zero. So yeah, so it looks like you can actually tweak your staff basically to fit your needs, I guess. So you can say put a bit more energy and then put a bit more cooldown speed, and that's total balance too, which doesn't make it. Yeah, that looks good. So let's craft it. And we can craft a robe as well, which determination, I'm not even sure what that does. And of course, there's no tooltips that explain that. Physical, I mean, let's just craft whatever there is. And we can, I guess, equip that. Double click. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so I guess now I have equipped the basic weapons, right? So let's see. Get sigils from monsters to learn new abilities at Dojo. Get pigments from monsters to improve abilities. Okay, so you can actually learn new stuff. That's always good. This guy doesn't even seem to react to me. Yeah, you just die. What? He just healed? What the hell? Okay, I guess I can just kite most of them. Although I imagine that character is not very good, like in more than 1v1, but let's stick with it for now. Let's see how that goes. Okay, the camera is seriously nauseating, especially when you need to read text. If there's no text on screen, it's kind of okay-ish. I think he just stuck. Okay, we got two abilities, and this is Dojo, so let's train. I can learn Decoy, and I can learn Protective Bubble. Sure, why not? Let's learn both. And I don't really have any slots for it. Alright then. I guess I don't care about Blink. Let's put a Decoy in there. Maybe swap those two. So F will be Decoy, R will be Healing. Protective Bubble instead of Healing. Yeah, so what I need to unlock other ones, I guess leveling up. Unlock at higher character level, okay. Okay, I have some resources. So how is this called? This is pigments. Okay, so I can use pigments to buff up my skills. Cool, I can get one more healing and one more mock. That sounds like a good idea. Why not? My primary attack. I'm gonna be using a lot of that. All right. Private stash. What do we have in private stash? We have nothing. Okay, but I know that I can stash stuff, so. Use the tree to bind yourself. Okay, I bound myself. Watch out for footsteps on the ground. They show that others might be around. I honestly don't see any footsteps. Do you see any footsteps? Oh, those ones. Okay, that's very subtle. Oh, you can actually hide in the grass. Okay, that is kind of interesting. That is the MOBA mechanic. Or something among those lines. This is pretty cool. So basically you can set up ambushes and like attack people out of the bushes. We got a revenant here. There you go. Have some of that. And kite the hell out of him. I don't think actually after buffing my attack it became any stronger. It certainly doesn't seem so. Okay, they don't really drop anything. Okay, where do I proceed? There's a lot of those guys. I'm just gonna hide because who cares about them. I don't think they actually, do they give me experience? Wait a second, let me try to kill one. Hey, dude, come here. Do you give me experience? Because if you do, I'm gonna farm the hell out of you. Oh god. Okay, I mean, they don't really damage me all that much. There's now a lot of them. And this attacks are actually doesn't seem to do, even the poisoning attack doesn't really seem to do any area of effect damage, which is annoying because I can kite them like this in packs, but I cannot really attack all of them. Oh god, I'm gonna die now. What was it? R, and then heal myself. Okay. Oh god, okay. I think I'm just gonna run away from them. Come on. Maybe that class is not a good pick for starting. Heal myself. I think let's run away from them. Okay. Will they actually chase me indefinitely? Is that how it works? I don't have any heals. Okay, this guy is now... What? How did I miss that? Okay, I think I now should be able... What? Why does my health go down? What is... What? The hell? Okay, that is very weird. I'm not sure if there's a latency issue, if there's just bugs. Okay, they don't net me any loot, but I do get some experience. Okay, and now I know that my class is not exactly the best one, so... Let's go ahead and switch to something that does more damage. So what was about more sight? That is 50 damage. What is the bow damage? 36. But I can kite them again. And this one is 38. Yeah, I think I'll just go with Scythe, because why the hell not? The sad thing is that I actually... Oh no, it resetted my weapons. Okay. And let's go with leather armor, I guess. Oh, that's actually way faster. All right, so basically depending on what skill set and what armor you have, you will have different characteristics, I guess. Okay. Okay, I got that. Skip tutorial. Yeah, I don't want to skip tutorial, but it would be nice to heal using something. Does this tree heal me? No. Is there no way to heal quickly? Really? Okay. Well, we got rid of those guys, so let's go and see what's at the end of the road, I guess. The camera is the most annoying part about this game. It's like, I really like the aesthetic of it, and I mean, skills are kind of okay. But the camera that is tied to mouse is a terrible idea. Please don't do that. Please change it to something sane. Okay, we finished the tutorial and now it suggests us EU Spring Server, which has prime time. I guess you get more stuff in prime time. Maybe that's the thing. So let's just jump in. I mean, 47 milliseconds ping should be fine. I'm playing with about the same, no, I think it's the Overwatch actually has a slightly better ping. Ah, hi there, special ninjas. All right, I mean, I have no idea about this game. I just finished the tutorial, so I'm gonna try not to play too bad and not hopefully not get ganked by crazy people who are already way over level. All right, you made it to the valley. We got O for list of opportunities and M for the map. Okay, let's have a look at the map. That is huge, assuming that is tiny thing over here, it's where we are. That's actually 544 players. That's not bad at all. I mean, oh no, wait, that's my position. I was like, no, okay, that's me being confused. Okay, defeat Revenant Clicker, defeat an Arachnid, defeat a Snatcher, defeat a Jailer Poacher. Okay, there are some practice dummies. Do I get any? Yeah, no, wait, oh, that's the stuff that I crafted, but I cannot equip it because I changed class. Okay. Got it. That looks overgrown, so let's go somewhere else, I guess. I can use run now. Cool, so I can actually run a bit faster. Although it is kind of short. Join a clan. I am not really a clan person, so I just want to check out the game and see if it's actually, you know, playable alone and to see if I can survive here, so that would be really nice. Not sure if that will happen, but you know, we'll figure it out eventually. Okay, you move slightly slower in the bushes, it seems. There is some on minimap, some resource icon, I believe. Is that spawned outside of the map? Yeah, it looks like it's spawned somewhere outside of the map, which is slightly disappointing. Clans will just kill me. Well, that, I guess I will just have to run away from them, or try to at least. We'll see how that works out. I mean, worst case, I'm gonna find a clan and then try to stream a bit while playing in clan. But yeah, let's see how that goes. I mean, so far I'm not dead. Maybe I will have enough time to, you know, get a feel for the game without people murdering me. Okay, that seems to be a very long road along the shoreline of something black. I guess it's corrupted water or something along those lines. It would be nice if they would give at least a bit of a story about the world, because it looks really cool. It's like, I would love to know more about it. Okay, there is some swords icon here. I'm not sure I want to go there, but let's just go and check it out. Impossible. I mean, let's just see how it goes. I'll take my chances at least for the beginning. There's a player group. I'll just evade that because no. Okay, there is a combat icon over here. I'm not sure what that. Oh, there's some guy. Hello. I'm friendly. Don't touch me, please. Thank you. Okay. Oh, I guess the sword icon means that he's already capturing the resources. Now, where the hell am I? Okay, I'm some very far away. What? What is... Now, that is some... Is that a network desynchronization or what is going on here? I'm just... Whoa! I saw the ping indicator somewhere. Oh, yeah, there it is. 70 milliseconds. Okay, yeah. Why is it when I'm starting moving, it just jumps to 100? That is so weird. Right. So far, not very exciting. Where's everyone? Like, where's the monsters? Where's the stuff to kill? Like, okay, I found one person and he didn't kill me, so that's a good start. Oh, here we go, Revenant. Let's kill some of those. Hey, dude, stop running away from me. Come on. There we go. Let's use that. Oh! Okay, now I'm teleporting all over the place. Okay, I guess that was the skill. We got a new skill. I wonder if that's actually for my class. Okay, come on. There we go, some heals. What is that icon? There is no tooltip. That's a bit disappointing. Okay, let's take that. We got some XP. We got... what is this skill thing? Phalanx, spear and shield. Okay, no, that's not for me. Alright. What does this person want from me? Thank you. Local. I guess we want a local. What? There we go. Yeah, so you see people not killing me, at least at the moment. There are some very big guys over there. Really wanna aggro all of them. How do I pull? Oh, there's a basic one. Let's kill that guy. Okay, I think I'm just gonna grind like tiny ones until I'm at least level 2 or something and get like proper weapons. Because that seems to be the way to go, but I'm not so sure. This player group down below. Nope, that missed. Let's try to kill that one maybe. Oh, there's a guy running again. Is that the same? Oh, whoa! What the hell? Nope! I'm out of here. Nope. Nope. What is happening? What is going on? No! You go away from me. Okay. I think we're safe. Is that person still chasing me? No, it doesn't seem so. Are we good? Now I'm afraid of people. You know, that's why I don't usually play PvP-oriented RPGs, because I'm terrified of this stuff. Okay, let's kill this revenant while nobody's watching. There we go. Get some loot. A bit of loot. I guess if you die, you lose everything. That's probably the case, right? That's what open PvP means. So let's try not to die and maybe farm a bit more experience, because we're almost leveled up. How did that miss? I thought I hit him. Come on. Guess ping is actually quite important in this game, considering it's all like target based. So maybe they want to either write the code in a way that it will compensate for like, 60 milliseconds is not a large ping, but I'm still managing to like miss things. So it would be nice to basically have a better netcode that would compensate for this, or close your servers. I mean, I think what if you use like something like AWS, you got Frankfurt servers, which should be like 20 milliseconds to me, I think. So yeah, let's go around those people over there. I don't want to get on their bad side. Okay, we're actually back to base. Who builds? I cannot even get in there. Why is this a thing? But there is... oh, okay, there's the entrance. Okay, cool. We got Dojo. What is this thing? Space to open. Somebody... oh, Reaver. I'll take that. Why not? I'll take that. Was that your thing? Did I just take your thing? We can try. Let me just learn some stuff. Shatter. Yeah, that's what I have, right? So you can learn patterns right now. Why? You can anymore. It's dangerous to go alone. Yeah, I kinda seen that already. So how do we team up? No idea, actually, if there are any friend lists or anything. Let me see. Controls, audio, events, map, opportunity, clan, respect, character. It doesn't seem so. Okay. Only clans. Alright. Looks like there are only clans. God, oh man, this camera, like if you do this, literally it's just nauseating for me. I don't know about you. Okay, but let's try to go along with our friend and farm some monsters over here. It's kind of terrifying that when you turn back on him, he just disappears. Okay, we got some people over here. Let's be friendly. Let's be friendly and not attack them. Okay, yeah, there we go. That is a lot of monsters. And a lot of people as well, so I don't want to randomly attack. Ow, that just hit me, actually. No! Okay, so basically anyone can attack your monsters and anyone can loot them, I assume. So, okay. Yeah. Oh, God. What? There we go. Loot everything. I got the revenant behind me. Oh. No, no, no. Get him. What is happening? What is going on in this game? Okay, now I'm trapped. Right, okay. And basically there's no way to know that something attacks you unless you turn around. Let me loot him. Oh, I got something good, I think. Okay, don't want to hurt those guys. So there's a revenant over there. Let's get some health and snap him. I mean, so far, you know, it's not bad. The camera is like the worst thing about the game so far. I really hope they will either change it completely or allow a different, like switching the modes basically. Ow, who's hitting me? Oh, that guy. Okay, first let me just take the loot. Yes, there you go. Oh, what? What? Oh, there we go. What? What? Lagging quite a bit. Okay, where's our dude Hackerman? Where did he actually go? I don't. Oh, there's someone running over there. No, that's not him. Oh, no! 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 I don't want to fight with you. There's too many of you now. Okay. How does the health regen work? Is there? I mean, I have the F, right? I just pressed F. Come on. Yeah, the controls are sometimes seems to be not quite responsive. I'm not sure why. Is that like a ping thing or is there just like a bugs? Actually, that F wasn't really helpful. Okay, where's the hacker man? I lost him somewhere. No, there's some burritos guys. Actually, almost a level. So maybe let's grind a bit more. Get a level. Okay, F. I think F now, and then I should be able to heal a bit by hitting him. There we go. That's what I want to see. What is this thing actually? This is a breath of Tal, whatever that means. Okay, something is happening. I mean, we're gaining experience. We're leveling up. There's two of them now. There we go. I'm in the skill, so I so far only have, what, 4? But, oh, level 2, nice, okay. Wonder if I actually lose my levels if I just die here right now. Because, like, normally you just lose loot, right? That's how it works. Oh, new skill. F, come on, heal. Yeah, that choppiness basically spoils all the combat, because it could be fun, but it's so choppy and, like, jumpy that it's really hard to... Yep, that screw you. No. What? No, no. Why do you hate me? No, fight with revenants. I don't care about you. No. Screw you. Get away from me. I'm friendly. Don't you see I'm friendly? Wait, there's no guards actually in the village, right? So there's like, yeah, good luck chasing me. I'm just gonna run away. There's no guards in the village, which is a bit weird, because you would think that there would be at least some protection from the, like, PvPing, at least in the camps. Like, even Ultima Online had that stuff. Wait, they can literally kill me over here. Are you kidding me? That is not the sort of PvP I would like to see. Come on, even Ultima Online in 90s had guards and a way to, like, hide from guys like this. This is not fun.
Do you recall a way to get full health? Your inventory will stay here if you recall.
Yeah, I'm not sure I'm liking the way it's done here. Plus, I'm yet to see the... Wait, what? What? What just happened? That is a completely different part of the map.
Increase run speed. Deal 25.
Is that some event? That's why it's showing me this piece of the map. I'm a bit confused.
I guess so. Okay, I can press Z. No, I can't. Wait, what?
It's now on a cooldown, but nothing happened. Okay then. And I lost all my inventory. And I have... Where am I? Oh, there I am. Okay, now I am here. I just appeared in... What? What is going on in this game? Right, okay, now there's some eggs. Fine, let's kill some eggs. Why not? I'm not sure what that does. But whatever. Not even sure I understand anymore what's going on in this game, aside from people killing me. There we go, let's kill that egg, and there's another egg. Okay. I have no idea what's going on here. Okay, those are just... And I'm still jumping back and forth, even so my ping is like 40 milliseconds. Well, was 40. Whoa, okay, that's a lot of eggs. Okay, don't hit the person. Dude, why you hit me? I just want to break eggs. I don't want to kill anyone. I'm a friendly guy, you see? There we go. Okay, let's not hit anyone. These guys just keep shooting at other one. Okay. I'm kind of curious what this event will end with. Or is it this just this control thing that spawned in the middle of the camp? Is that what it is? No, okay, Dodger, can I do anything? I don't have sigils because those assholes took them from me. Okay, I can actually switch class on the fly. That is kind of cool. Okay, I like that. Okay, but wait, how do I... I cannot exit from this menu unless I select something. I see, okay. Leather is fine. Yeah, okay. So what is the building part of the game? I read that there is a way to build settlements and stuff. But I don't really see anything to do with that. It's probably... Maybe it's just not implemented yet. Sweep, hemorrhaging chains, capping spring. Yeah, that doesn't seem so. Maybe you can upgrade those things. But it doesn't seem so as well. Okay. Okay. Yeah, okay, of course they looted that stuff, and I don't have any more loot, so it looks like without the clan, really, there's nothing to do in this game, basically, because you're just gonna get wrecked. But anyway, let's try venturing out once more. I mean, at least I'm level 2 now, so maybe if I level up enough, even with the basic noob equipment, I might be able to survive, at least for a bit. Let's see how that goes. Yep, what? Okay then, yeah, synchronization code is definitely not quite up to par yet. Also, I want to note the huge map that literally has nothing on it. That is a bit disappointing. Like, when you play MMORPGs, you want to be entertained, right? You want to run around and have, like, things to do here and there. And so far, I've explored, like, one-tenth of the map, I guess. And there's like one medium revenant camp on it, and that's it. I'm not sure what the creators are expecting people to do here, because it's a bit
you know, a bit deserted, let's put it this way. What is this thing here? It looks like you shall not pass one ward. Oh, right. I have no idea what that means. I guess... I have no idea what it does. Right, let's continue. There's some people over here. And that looks like a camp. Another one. Okay, I can bind to it. Because why not? I'm curious how the hell I teleported from here to here I've died, because I'm pretty sure I was bound to this camp. But okay. Let's try to find something else. And not to die preferably to horrible people who just chase you and murder you. I didn't even have any good loot at the moment, so it's like, I mean, come on. Right, there's some more weird looking stuff. Okay, this camera makes me kind of sick at this point. And again, there is literally nothing around, which, like, what am I supposed to do here? There's so much empty space. Okay, let's use run and run up. New opportunity, study the map. So is the idea basically to explore the whole map so that then you can see all the opportunities right away and kind of participate in them? Is that what you kind of need to do? I'm not sure I like that idea. Okay, there are some monsters over there. I assume that's a monster logo. So let's go ahead and try that. Stay again out of the map, really. Okay, go here, go up. It looks like it's again the monster camps pound outside of the map borders. Oh, there's actually some jailers here, so let's kill a jailer, because why not? It actually looks like a human person. Yeah. Oh wow, he's actually kiting me. That's interesting. Okay, we got some stuff. Where did that guy go? They actually use grass. That is kind of cool. I like that. What? He just clipped through the forest, basically. Stop kiting me. Stop doing that. Die already. There we go. I can actually go upgrade my skills. I think I shall do that while I still am alive and have the resource on me. So that sounds like a good idea. Because I wouldn't want to just die and lose it again, which would be disappointing. There's some people there. I'm not sure I want to go there. Right. Come on, game. Stop jumping around. That's kind of getting a bit annoying. Okay. Together with the camera that is tied to mouse and absolutely nauseating, those jumps are really annoying. Okay, I think I'm just gonna upgrade my basic. I need a red for that. Oh, I don't even have resources for that. No. Okay, you know what? Let's try. So I think they should, the blue ones go for, no. So I can select scythe. I think the blue ones go for robes, right? So I can actually bump up. No, it's not rope. Okay. Stuff. Is that the stuff thing? No, it's not. It would be nice if they had some sort of reference here to see, like, what the hell can I upgrade with that? That's yellow. Mail. Ah, okay. I can actually upgrade mail. Ignore pain. Think. Yeah, why not? Let's upgrade ignore pain. Why not? So, leather. And let's go back to Warscythe. Got some flukes. Maybe I'll just drop it into the... Why do I have a bow? Let me just stash it here. There we go. At least I won't lose it once I'm dead. Please give me my scythe. Come. I just switched to scythe. What the hell? Oh, I have to click apply probably, right? Yeah. No. No? I think I found another bug. All right. War scythe and leather. Apply. Now it's switched. Yes, good, finally. All right, let's go try to find a bit more resources. And yes, there's a person fighting jailers. There's a lot of jailers here. Not sure where they come from, but let them fight. I'm jumping around the map again. That... Come on, game, get your shit together. There was a jailer's camp just over here, right? That's where we fought them last time. Come on. It's not so hard to synchronize the states over the network. Animal pack fallen nearby. Well, it was probably someone did that, so I'm not gonna go and find them. Ah, there we go. Let's find this jailer guard. Oh, he's actually preventing me from using skills. Okay. Let's get rid of this one first. Come here. Yeah, the combat definitely feels clunky. Let's grab that stuff. Okay. Nope, missed that. But I mean, again, you know, this is early access, so I think they definitely have a lot of work. What? Is that lagging or is that some skills? Sometimes it's actually really hard to tell whether you was like stopped by skill or whether server is just lagging and you cannot actually use anything. Oh, that looks interesting. There is a jailer sniper. Come here. Come here, I told you. There you go. Now he's dead. What is this thing? This is Mind of Tal. That's not a person, right? I want to do PvP. I'm terrible at PvP, so I'm not going to do that. I'm going to hide from everyone and run away back to base and stash everything into my storage. There we go. Okay. Oh, I got another blue essence. Reagent used in a workshop to increase in bonus. Oh, so this is basically for changing, for buffing up the stats of the crafted weapons. Yeah, but if I want to craft any weapons, I actually need to do those events or like horde mode things to get any reagents to craft stuff. So I don't know. I mean, the leveling are super slow. It's like I've been killing those guys for ages now, but I'm still level 2 and I only got 200 XP. This 30 XP per book. So I need to kill like what, 90 guys to get a level. That is a lot. Totem energy drain. Can I learn it? I need a dodger to learn. Okay. Yeah, let's try to find a resource thingy. Wonder if there are actually any. No, I don't care about you. I don't want to fight you. If you use the med and look at the pigments, tells you where to get stuff. Uh-huh. Okay. Oh, I see. Okay, so there's actually this text labels. Ah, okay. But it kind of covers half of the map. So jailer's camp, meteorite. Yeah, okay. I don't see any resource things around me, which is slightly disappointing. So let's try searching. What is this thing? Private stash in the middle of nowhere. Because makes sense. Because video games, I guess. Oh wait, do all the stashes are actually different? So that like if you stash it in one of them, you cannot get it from another one. I see. Oh man, that is kind of hardcore. Which means that because I stashed it down there, I actually have to go to that settlement to retrieve my stuff. I see where this game goes. And I know quite a few people who would enjoy a lot of that kind of gameplay, but I think I'm definitely not one of them. Especially considering the open PvP aspect. Caravan storage, that seems like somebody's thing and I cannot really do anything to it. Stash ruin. What is this? This is a unclaimed settlement. Oh, okay. So that's how you build. Requires clan and resources. Oh, I guess when you have a clan, you can build and claim settlements. Ah, that explains the building part. So it seems like straightforward, right? Bring siege offering to start a siege. I have no idea what it does. Okay, so it looks like most of the content available in the game now is actually focused towards like PvP and player-to-player interaction. So there is literally zero PvE in this game. Like this, I guess, horde mode events with resource scavenging is the closest one you can find. It's just yeah, you go fight them. I don't care about them. Again, this strange cat universe that says hello in Russian. I'm fine with that. No idea what is this, but whatever. All right. Meteorite crash. So does that mean that resources are sort of very rare as well, and they are also focused around like making people fight for them? Is that the thing? Because if it is, then this is definitely not my game. Okay, we got some people here, player group. Let's see, there are some monsters down here. Arachnids. I think I have a quest to kill an arachnid, so let's just do that. Come here. Nope. Come on. Okay, let's try to kill arachnid. I think defeat revenant, things to do. Yeah, it doesn't really show anything. There we go. Yay, okay, I actually got something out of it. Let's kill another one. Do I get anything? It doesn't like seems like I actually get anything for those tasks or whatever, opportunities. There we go. It's almost dead, kill it, kill it, kill it. Nope, don't run away from me. Okay, what did I get? What is this? This is, come on, tooltip. Tooltip? No. Okay, tooltip sometimes does more. Let's see, opportunities. So, talk someone in local chat, defeat arachnid. Okay, so they literally doesn't do anything. It's like, hey, you can do that. Yeah, that's kind of cool, but what's the point then? I can pretty much find out that myself. And it's now stuck in the trees, which is fine by me. I'll just murder it. What? How did that miss? Okay, I mean, I can see how that missed because it was too far away. Okay, I have actually a lot of things, but I don't think, like, for crafting. What was the nearest settlement? There's one right below me, so let's go. Let's try to proceed there and not die while meeting some angry people who will hate me. Okay, run. I guess using roads maybe make you run a bit faster. It actually seems so. Okay, here we go. That's a settlement. Wait, what? Oh, cow. Oh, come on, the ping is even not that bad. It's like, why are you jumping so much? Okay. So what is, oh, now it says lonely prowl. Yeah, let's learn that. Why not? Makes you invisible as long as you do not get too close to player or mobs. That actually sounds way more useful than I sort of don't want to change the drain life thing. Okay, sprint mail. Let's buff up this one, I guess. Apply. So, select leather again. Apply. Please apply. There we go. Ritual totem. Yeah, no. Oh, there's a limit to the abilities you can actually learn. Okay, so you have to be careful and first learn the ones that you actually want to learn. I see how that works. Okay, this is the stash that I used before. No, it's not, but I'm anyway gonna stash everything in it. Stash everything in it, I said. There we go. It's a weird double click doesn't work, right click doesn't have stash prompts. It's definitely early access. Right, so what I need to craft a war site plus one. I need a ton of obsidian and flux item, which I have 20. So the main problem is obsidian, which I have no idea where to get. I guess for leather armor, it's leather, yeah. Okay, but yeah, I guess it would be a good point to stop the stream. Man, the camera is just killing me. It's sort of, I can see what sort of game it is, but wait, we even have an active XP multiplier to 100%. And it is that slow with the multiplier. Not a fan of that, not a fan. But yeah, I mean, you get the idea. So this was The Exiled. You can actually try it for 7 days for free right now on Steam if you want to. See early access. I don't know. I mean, it seems to be heavily focused on PvP, yet there are some glaring server problems, like this stuff, for example. That needs to be fixed, and some synchronization issues and some ping issues, and you know, it's kind of raw, but I'm guess some people are gonna enjoy it. So thank you for watching, and as always, I guess see you next time. Bye.